Hi everyone, it's Kathy Rose Creations. I thought I'd do another little vlog. I'm gonna try and do this like once a week, maybe. I don't know. Anyway, pardon the glasses. I can't see anything without them. I thought I'd show you what I've been up to. I kind of like went crazy making some shabby chic flowers. I had showed a video on these, on how to make them, and I think I also showed this one, which was made from coffee filters. I can't remember. Anyway, I sort of started watching other videos and had a lot of fabric scraps, and I thought, okay, well, I'm going to try some different flowers. So bear with me. I'm going to move my computer here to kind of show what I've been up to. Let me see if I can. Oops. I don't know, can you see that? It's a whole pile of different kind of flowers. All different kinds. Some fabrics, some have a little tulle and little bling on them, or pearls, or some of them are made out of suede, cotton, all kinds of things. I love this one. It's got an image, little pin thing. I don't know where I got that. Anyway, okay, hang on. Close your eyes. I think I'm gonna leave before you visit my I don't know what actually everybody got to see, but I really, really like this one. It's just made out of some cotton fabric, and I just kind of gathered it, and I kind of roughed it up. You know, I was watching a video, and this gal was, like, rubbing it on her palms to rough it up, and I was like, I couldn't get it to do that. So I used a sanding block. I don't know if... Maybe you don't know what a sanding block is. This one's called Sand Blaster by 3M. And it's kind of, whoops, it's kind of like a rough thing. It's a sanding sponge, actually. Works great for roughing up the edges of these little flowers, no matter what the fabric. I mean, like this one is just some old cotton. Actually, this was an old sheet that I tore up. And then I put a little tulle on it and a pearl. I thought it turned out kind of cute. Anyway, I made dozens of those things. And that was fun. And also, I've been working on some more altered envelopes, which I have another video out there for the altered envelopes. This one, just a plain, one of those junk envelopes you get in your bills and stuff. I don't know why they still send those things to people, because most people pay with their bank anyway, you know, e-banking. Anyway, I covered it with tissue paper that I got at Dollar Tree. Very pretty tissue paper, actually. It comes in kind of this lavender and then pink in the same little pack. And then that's just a butterfly cut out of a magazine. And then on this side, in order to give it a little more strength, I put some purple paper underneath it and then covered it with the tissue paper. I thought it turned out really well. I need to get some magnets to hold these things closed. And I made another one of my ones with the coffee filters. And I'm probably going to do something else to it. I'm not sure. I did stamp it with a text stamp and or script stamp. And using stays on. I made this one for my sister for when she gets back. I'm going to take it down to her. It's covered with the paper that I got in Japan, and on the inside I put some book pages or book page. And then in the window I actually put an image of a cat and a dictionary page. And the dictionary page is hairball. I thought that was kind of clever. And again, I used hair ties for closing it. That turned out pretty well. There's another one of the ones made with the tissue paper. And this was just a plain, again, junk envelope. And I used those shiny stickers that I also got at Dollar Tree. And a doily. And another sticker. And this one is made with a napkin. And I stamped it again with the stays on and the script stamp. And I also did a bird on the back. This one is a different tissue paper. Also from the Dollar Tree. And very pretty, very feminine. And this image is out of a seed catalog, I think, and out of a magazine. Then I kind of put the dots using a gel pen. And I thought that turned out really well. And here's another butterfly or moth. I'm not too sure which is which. And a little bit of this sticky trim that I got at Michael's. And I thought it turned out kind of pretty. Oh, on the inside, I don't know if you can see it. Let me see if I can. My lighting in here is really crappy. Hold on. I hope that helps. Let's go for a ride. Okay. I put some lace, a little lace doily piece. Actually, no, it's a piece that I cut out of a tablecloth. I don't know if you can see that. And I just kind of stuck it on there. It was kind of a surprise, you know, when you open it up. And I think that's all that I haven't shown before. And I already showed you my little mini albums. And if you haven't watched my video on the mini albums, I think I did it in my last vlog, but they were a direct response to the one that Lori Richardson Haley made. Journal. Oh, life cues. I did week 8, 9, and 10. Week 8 was what would you do with an extra 24 hours? I didn't really know what to do. I didn't really have my mojo. My muse was kind of like... So, I put the clock and 24 all over the place. And then I said, I don't know, spend time with family. I mean, yeah, I think that's what I would do. Week 9 is what is the best book you've read lately? I read a lot. I use audiobooks a lot. And I never ride in the car or drive in the car that I don't have an audiobook going. And I also listen to them when I'm doing art, if I'm not video recording anything. But this is the one for the book, And the older lady is saying, what was the best book you've recently read? And the lady in blue says, I just finished The Silkworm by Robert Galbraith. Robert Galbraith, if you don't know, is J.K. Rowling that wrote the Harry Potter books. These are murder mysteries, and she's written two, and I think there's a third one coming out shortly. They're excellent. Excellent. And you really need to read them in sequence because it's the same character, the same detective, and it's really more interesting. I keep wiggling this thing around. It's more interesting to read the or listen. I actually use audiobooks, but to read them in order. And there's the two ladies. They have their crowns and they have their wings, like all ladies should have. And then this one, and I didn't do wings on this lady or a crown. This was, what is your favorite quote? And then I put on here, I couldn't decide on only one. I had a lot of favorite quotes, but probably my absolute all-time favorite is, well-behaved women rarely make history. I love, love, love that quote. I love it. My friend actually bought me a t-shirt she found with that quote on it. And then the second one I like is, forgiveness is the scent of the violet upon the heel that crushed it. And I found out that Peta Thompson, Miss Lady Petals Creations, also likes that quote. So we were on the same page. And I used one of my Prima doll stamps, and I put a separate metallic skirt on her and then colored her with colored pencils. And then I put some little paper roses and some more little flowers to kind of denote the violets. Anyway, I thought she turned out really good. I don't know if you can tell, the dress is very shiny, and I've also got a little glitter on her. So I thought she turned out very well. The next one that I'm going to have to do is, if you had just one wish, what would it be? I'm still thinking about it. So I haven't done the Journaling Crazy Island style ones. Let's see, what else have I been doing? I was experimenting with putting tissue paper on music pages. Mr. Victor Crafter, and if you haven't visited his channel, you really need to, did this. Before I put the tissue on here, I did do some stenciling using a dimensional, I think I used actually grout or something. What did I use? Anyhow, it wasn't modeling paste, it was just some other industrial thing. And then I put a little bit of these things. Okay, the brain died. Anyhow, that's what I did. And I used plain white tissue paper and I put it on some music pages. And I thought it turned out really nice. It's interesting. I'll probably use it as a background on a journal. And I also kind of experimented with the book pages. I don't know if you can see this. And I used some dimensional stuff for that. I have another Prima doll that I actually made her skirt out of embossed paper. It came that way, and it had little dots. And I just rubbed a blue stamp pad over it. And then I kind of colored her with colored pencils, and then I put some flat back pearls. And I had stamped her on book pages, and I might put her in my paper doll book. I haven't excited, Jeff.
Speaking of the paper doll book, I did do one more paper doll. And I did say in my last vlog that I might do a tutorial on this, even though it's like really, really simple. But with the new Cinderella movie coming out, I thought, I'm going to do Cinderella. So I actually drew this paper doll, and you'll notice she has her eyes closed because I can't draw eyes. Anyway, I drew her a long time ago, and she's just been hanging around in an envelope. I put some glitter and wings on her and a crown. The crown is some bling. And at the top, it says Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo. And I have a space down here, and I've been contemplating maybe drawing some mice and a pumpkin. I don't know. Haven't seen the movie yet. Want to see it? It's like, you know, the little girl in me, I guess. But, let's see, I think that's about everything I have to show. Let's see what's been going on. Oh, I did go to Joanne and Michael's today because Joanne's had a 60% coupon. Couldn't pass that up. Excuse me. My smoothie. orange banana smoothie. But, I bought a big 32-ounce thing of Mod Podge at Joanne's, and what a deal, 60% off. That was goodbye. And I got a couple other things that were on sale. I got, haven't decided what I'm going to do with them yet, but I thought they were kind of cute. They're wood veneer by Studio Calico. One is people. And the other one is birds. And sorry about the glare. And they're like little teeny weeny wood veneers. The bird one has 71 itty bitty birds. And this one has 63 people. And they're very thin. So I might put them in my journals. So I just use them as some sort of embellishment. I thought they were really cute. And they were on sale 50% off, so I got them for $3.99 each. So I thought that was a pretty good buy. I'm kind of like on a buying diet. Oh, God, I walked through the paper section. I kept wanting to buy the paper, and I didn't buy one sheet. So I was good. What else? Oh, after I got done going to Joanne's and Michael's, I ran into the grocery store. And while I was reaching for a can of soup, I had another one come down and hit my big toe. And I was wearing sandals. Ow! 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 It hurt so bad. And it was like, oh my God. Well, now my toe is all puffy. And it has a big black and blue mark right from the toenail, where the toenail and the bottom, or the toenail and the toe at the bottom, you know. Anyway, it's kind of like dark there. Myla, my toenail's going to fall off. What can I say? It really hurts. It still hurts. I don't even know if I can put a pair of shoes on. It's like stupid. It comes from being short and you got to reach up stuff and it fell down. Anyway, this video is 19 minutes, so it's time to wrap it up, Kathy. Thanks for watching. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. And if you like this particular one, please give me a thumbs up. And be nice to each other. Be nice to everyone. And peace. Peace.